Now, I'm listening to a bounce that I made of the song that I'm working on. It's just the arrangement. Just listening to great sounds. I'm deciding whether the form is good, if the arrangement is what I want. And so the next step is I'm gonna open the live and then I'm gonna duplicate what sounds I wanted. Okay. Maybe I can fix that a bit. Anyway, I'm gonna see which sounds of this I want to be produced by those machines and synths. And then I just mess around with the sound live there, with the knobs and stuff, because again, this will be played in live. Some of that will go to the keyboards, you know? So some will be Ableton, but some will be playing live through the keyboard, so then I can mess around with it live. So that's what I'm gonna be doing today. This is the studio, that's my daughter. That's her drum. She's gonna help me film. That's her drum. And yep, that's me.
This is his little computer over here.
Each one of these has a different kind of sound.
Yeah.
That one sounds like much like distortion and some crazy sound. This is more like old school sound, which I really like.
That can play really good.
Much modern sounds, and that's a drum basically. This is a drum. And each one of these is a different part of the drum. So you take the computer and say, here, for example, this is the boom, 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 right?
Boom,
like
boom, 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 boom.
The floor one's over there, right?
Yes.
And then the other one is the tss, 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 tss. And so why is this good? Because then you can mess around with the sound when each of those sounds, right? This little piano controls that little, you know, program. And this one over here is the bass. It's for the bass. It sounds like really amazing. It's I think it's actually analog, as I understand it. It sounds amazing. It's the best one. So look, so far.
So good.
Oh yes, oh yes. Let's try again. Listen to that. Dude called Mario.